हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द लेक्चर दैट इज नॉलेज टेक एट होम फ्रॉम एनाटॉमी पेपर फर्स्ट एंड पेपर सेकंड एंड ओवरऑल द व्हाट यू हैव गेन फ्रॉम ऑल द सिलेबस ऑफ एनाटॉमी. So first of all, anatomy, in the first BHMS anatomy, you have to, the utility of the anatomy for your second BHMS, third BHMS, fourth BHMS and in your practice life. So the hints, the knowledge, the approach that you have to take at home from anatomy paper first as well as from paper second. So as all of you know, most of you people utilize the book of B.D. Chaurasia, and some of you utilize the book of that Inderbir Singh. It is clear cut mentioned that take at home what you have learned from that particular region anatomy. It is given in a pink color, or in the missing book it may be in other colors, it may be a little bit blue color. The take at home what knowledge, what you have learned from the anatomy. This lecture is exclusively based on this. Only the take at home message and take at home what you have gained from the anatomy. So anatomy is the study of the structure of the human body, human anatomy, say always. So in the human anatomy you have to study whole. For the convenience of the students of anatomy, for the teachers, there are various types of anatomy. This is summary. The anatomy should be may be studied under regions, various regions. We have made the various regions of our body: the upper extremity, pectoral region, then head, neck, face, head and brain. This is included in papers first. I again revise the surface, various types of anatomy. There is a radiological anatomy, there is a topographical anatomy, there is a surface anatomy, there is a systemic anatomy also. All the system of the body may be studied under the knowledge of anatomy only. But that is not convenient. The most of the world has accepted the anatomy as a regional anatomy. Whatever in that region that comes is studied under this topic or in that region. So that is regional anatomy. There is a radiological anatomy, then the practical osteology, one of the all the bones are studied under that anatomy. So various types of anatomies are there. But the university has accepted, the CCS has also accepted the regional anatomy. Some deemed university, they have accepted another type of regions above the diaphragm paper first and below the diaphragm paper second. That is a description, that is a dividation of the marks in various other universities also. So in this first BHMS, what you have learned from the anatomy. So in the upper extremity, what you have learned from the upper extremity, so number of clinical things, the surface anatomy, the surface markings of the anatomy. So for the upper extremity, for example, the pectoral region. In the pectoral region, although this pectoral region comes interior to the pectoral region, there is a thorax. But pectoral region comes in paper first. Pectoral region consists of pectoral muscles, pectoralis major, minor, and subclavius, and pectoral nerves. In this region, in the life of a in the female, there is a secondary sexual organ, that is mammary gland, is on the located on the pectoral region. So, and then in the anatomy of a pectoral region of a male, there are rudimentary breasts are mammary glands are rudimentary. So, no question of in detail, no question of study of anatomy of a mammary gland of male. They are rudimentary only. The female mammary gland should be studied very cautiously and especially the female or the girl doctors must be considered. They must examine the mammary gland. You must know. See, mammary glands are located in the superficial fascia of the superficial fascia of the pectoral region. So it is enclosed, and under cover of the mammary gland there is a deep fascia, and then the pectoral muscles are there. So one must have to keep in mind the whole anatomy of a mammary gland from the pectoral region. So you should able to identify the interior by examination of a mammary gland. In the for the first BHM student, position of the nipple, differences, age-wise differences in a newly parous woman, in a woman who has been given birth to the child, and in elderly, the various disorders are there regarding the mammary gland. So examination should be there. Then the see from the neck, the see on the neck, there are numerous cervical glands are there. These cervical glands gets enlarged if there is an infection interiorly. It gets enlarged, especially the superficial. The cervical glands get enlarged if interiorly there is an infection in the interior, that leads to the enlargement of the cervical gland. Then see on the surface of the body, what you palpate here is nothing but the acromion. This acromion is subcutaneous, it is under cover of the skin only. So then the clavicle, in case of a clavicle, you have to you can palpate. It is subcutaneous. Clavicle is subcutaneous even in the bodybuilders also. So you should know the supraclavicular fossa. Yeah, there is a fossa. Supraclavicular fossa, that fossa is called as a supraclavicular fossa, and infraclavicular fossa also. So there is a depression above the clavicle. So, and what are the structures that comes under the supraclavicular triangle? Above the clavicle, the triangle is there. So what are the structures passing through that supraclavicular triangle? Especially the jugular veins. Then in the back. This is the shoulder region. On the shoulder region, you can it is very difficult to palpate the coracoid process here. You can't palpate your own coracoid process, but you can palpate from the scapular region, the spine of the scapula. You can palpate the spine. It is subcutaneous. So, and the for the counting of the ribs, the below the inferior angle of the scapula, there is a 8th rib. So you can count the ribs, that helps on the surface of the body for counting of the ribs. Then see deltopectoral triangle. Here is a triangle. A triangular depression is there at the junction of the anterior fibers of the deltoid and pectoral muscle. There is a deltopectoral triangle. Deltopectoral triangle. This deltopectoral triangle is important in this on the for the surface marking of the pectoral region. Then the arm, this one is the shoulder region. So on the shoulder region you can make many the deltoid. This one is a deltoid having anterior fibers, lateral fibers and posterior fibers. Anterior fibers gets origin from the lateral end of the lateral one third of the clavicle and acromion lateral fibers from the acromion of the scapula and posterior fibers from the posterior fibers of the deltoid. So all of these three fibers comes together and is inserted on the deltoid tuberosity of the humerus. So you can palpate your own deltoid tuberosity also. Deltoid tuberosity. Now anteriorly, the portion from the shoulder to the elbow is called as an arm. It's called as an arm. Then this arm consists of number of things. Number of things are there on the and on the in the interior of the arm. Arm is divided into anterior compartment and posterior compartment by an intermuscular septum that is attached to the lateral border of the humerus and medial border of the humerus. So arm is being divided into anterior compartment and posterior compartment. Posterior compartment consists of only two heads of the medial and lateral heads of the tricep. The long head gets origin from the infraglenoid tubercle. So that tricep is the muscle. आपल्याला इंजेक्शन द्यायला लागतात ना. सो दॅट बॅक ऑफ द आर्म इज वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टंट रिजन इन युअर लाईफ. तुमच्या जीवनामध्ये बॅक ऑफ द आर्म इज इम्पॉर्टंट. सी द सर्फेस मार्किंग ऑफ द रेडियल नर्व. रेडियल नर्व पासेस इन बिटवीन द सी दिस वन इज द मेडियल हेड अँड दिस वन इज द लॅटरल. इन बिटवीन देम द रेडियल नर्व पासेस. So you must able to locate the surface marking of the radial nerve during intramuscular. Generally, see, the intramuscular injections are given in the deltoid also. They may be given in the lateral head of the tricep, lateral head of the tricep. So unfortunately, if the patient is weak, debilitated, sometimes the needle may get injured to the radial nerve. And what is the result? Result is a wrist drop. Wrist get dropped. Patient is unable to do the extension of the hand. So care must be taken that you should know the exact location of the radial nerve coming from the radial groove and comes again into the anterior compartment of the arm and supplies the whole muscles of the posterior compartment of the forearm. See, then the pectoral muscles are supplied by pectoral nerves, medial and lateral pectoral nerves. The origin insertions we have already discussed. Then the anterior compartment of the arm consists of three muscles. One is the bicep brachii having two origins, short head and long head. Short head from the coracoid process, tip of the coracoid process, and long head from the supraglenoid tubercle. Both the heads that comes together here, this one is a bicep brachii. This bicep brachii is inserted on the radial tuberosity, on the radial tuberosity. So what is the clinical things? They are important in the anterior of the arm, anterior of the arm. So the most important thing is the brachial artery. Brachial artery, when you take the pulsation, when you take the blood pressure, at that time the brachial artery pulsations, the sounds coming from the brachial artery pulsation is being heard as a systolic blood pressure, and when the sound disappears, that is a diastolic blood pressure. So clinical important things, and one more, the median nerve passes medial to the brachial artery in the arm. So radial nerve, median nerve, and one more clinical anatomy of this is medial condyle. This one is a medial condyle of the humerus and this one is a lateral condyle of the humerus. Exactly behind the medial condyle of the humerus, the ulnar nerve passes. Ulnar nerve passes exactly behind the medial condyle. So when you sometime you get a contusion on your medial condyle of your elbow, at that time there is a tingling, or that the ulnar nerve gets contused and it gives a tingling sensation in your fingers, because the flexors, all the flexors of the hand, the flexor, it is one of the flexor muscles that supplies to the muscles of the hand mainly. So it may get a pain and there is a tingling sensation. So in the surface marking of the body, behind the medial condyle, the ulnar nerve passes. So we must think about the ulnar nerve. Ulnar nerve passes behind the medial condyle of the humerus. Then in the posterior compartment of the arm, there are huge muscles. There are 12 muscles, they are present in the posterior compartment of the forearm. And in the anterior compartment of the forearm, there are flexor muscles. There are 7 flexor muscles. So, flexor they origin from the common flexor origin. Common flexor origin, 7 flexor muscles. All the flexors of the forearm gets origin from the medial condyle. All the extensors of the forearm gets origin from the lateral condyle of the humerus. You must remember that all the muscles of the back of the forearm gets origin from the lateral condyle and flexor muscles from the medial condyle of the humerus. Now, in the anterior compartment of the arm, the brachial artery, median nerve, then musculocutaneous nerve, a small nerve that extends only to the cubital fossa, a cutaneous branch is derived to the lateral aspect of your forearm. Lateral aspect of your forearm that supplies to the cutaneous innervation to the lateral aspect of the forearm. That musculocutaneous nerve is also there in the arm. So in the anterior compartment, the brachial artery, median nerve and musculocutaneous nerve, these are the nerves. Then one must keep in mind that axillary nerve that winds the surgical neck of the humerus here. Axillary nerve winds the surgical neck of the humerus here. So during giving the intramuscular injections, axillary nerve supply to only 2 muscles. One is the deltoid and another is the teres minor. So these are some clinical anatomy important points. Then regarding the shoulder and clavicle. Clavicle sometimes by a strong contusion of a hard object. Ekadi dankat vastu ite lagli. If there is a strong contusion, the clavicle may get fractured. So clavicle generally gets fractured. For your kind information, clavicle gets fractured at the junction of the medial 2/3. Never forget medial 2/3, not medial 1/3. Medial 2/3 and lateral 1/3. So that is a weak point of the clavicle where the clavicle gets fractured. And treatment for the clavicle. If a patient comes to you in your OPD, for example, if he has got a contusion on the clavicle, what happens? Clavicle hold the whole weight of our extremity. He sagla extremities, upper extremities, vasan clavicle varun sternum var aitha. Sternum varun ribs varun vertebra varun kali ground var. Below, on the ground. So, if a patient comes in your OPD like this, because he can't hold, if there is a fracture of the clavicle, the patient cannot hold the weight of his extremity. So, what is the treatment for either Odni or muffler? You may utilize or a 4 or 5 inches bandage. You may use and make a 8-shaped bandage. Make a to hold and keep that bandage behind, not in front, to avoid the compression to the neck. Patimagun bandhayacha the 8-shaped bandage. Pudun nahi. Not from the front side. It should be tied from behind. And lift both the extremities. Lift the both the extremities like this to avoid all the weight of the both extremities will fall on the back of your neck. Lakshat gya. Clavicle fracture cha patient tumcha OPD your clinic madhi ala. Tar sagalyat pahilyanda first of all, that is a treatment. Bandage pan milta. See, there is a bandage available, maybe available at your OPD or at your clinical level, at your clinical or anywhere. So you have to make a English letter S chapel. English letter 8, not S, English letter S, 8 shaped bandage. Such a bandage should be there. And see, you have to see here, like this. If a patient comes, you know, in your OPD, you have to tie a bandage in this way. Like this, and lift both the extremities above, and all the weight should fall on back of your knee, and tie it and lift the extremities above. हे सगळं वजन पाठीमागे मानेच्या पाठीमागे गेलं पाहिजे. And lift your extremities like this. So this is a treatment for the fracture of the clavicle. In your clinic, so never forget in the life, if such a patient, so if patient comes in your OPD like this, by holding his elbow or by holding his forearm, that means mostly the patients who hold their elbow, they are either the dislocation of the humerus or the fracture of the clavicle. So further x-ray than that you will do, but before to that, that is a treatment also for the clavicle. The H-shaped bandage is only treatment, and make the two fragments close together, the clavicle will heal within a month or 2 months. Automatically, that healing is a tendency of the bone. So they make a X-ray and bring the two fragments. Fragment means tukade. Both the fragments together, they will heal fastly if you provided a good diet and rest to the patient. Eight-shaped bandage is the treatment for the fracture of the clavicle. Then, the another anatomically importance of the shoulder joint. See, shoulder joint, sometimes a shaft is a common site of the fracture of the shoulder joint. But shoulder joint get dislocated. It gets dislocated inferiorly, because the capsular ligament of the shoulder joint is weak inferiorly rather than above. See, for your kind information, shoulder joint never dislocate above. Why? Because there is a rotatory cuff muscles. What are the rotatory cuff muscles? Subscapularis, supraspinatus, infraspinatus and teres major. These are the four rotatory cuff muscles. Four tendons do not allow to dislocate the humerus above. That is the clinical importance of the shoulder joint. Why shoulder joint never dislocate above? Due to the rotatory cuff or musculotendinous cuff. Very rarely it dislocate anteriorly, and very rarely posteriorly. But in most of the cases it dislocate inferiorly. Then in a strong contusion of a hard object, there may be fracture of the condyles of the humerus may get fractured sometimes by a strong contusion. There may be injury to the ulnar nerve, and there may be injury to the radial nerve, especially a faulty technique of an intramuscular injection. Generally, you people prefer for the intramuscular injections, you prefer the gluteal region. You prefer the gluteal region only rather than the arm, back of the arm. Don't inject in the arm. Prefer the deltoid. Then in the tricep, you try to in a week. Vayaskar patient asel, 50 varcha asel, ashakta asel, tar he has a muscular atrophy, a physiological muscular atrophy is there, and the needle may enter injured to the radial nerve. The care must be taken that during the intramuscular injections, we should try to avoid the giving injections in the tricep. Now comes the cubital fossa. In the cubital fossa, it is used for mainly two purposes. One is the universally blood pressure is measured in the cubital fossa. to auscultation of a brachial artery. When sound starts, that is, if you release the pressure, and if the sound starts, that is a systolic. If sound disappears, that is a diastolic blood pressure. Very easy. Then, in case of an axilla, if there is an infection, suppuration in the upper limb, the axillary lymph nodes get enlarged, or any other interior infection in the pectoral region or around the shoulder may enlarge the axillary lymph nodes. Axillary lymph nodes, there are five groups of axillary: anterior, posterior, central, supra, clavicular. These are the various groups around the axilla for upper extremity for a lymphatic drainage. So that lymph nodes, normal lymph node and enlarged lymph node, can be differentiated by physician and even by the students also. Enlargement of the lymph node by palpating. If the enlargement is there, there may be pain by palpating the lymph nodes. So that is a clinical importance of the pluvital fossa. Then intravenous infusions. When you want to give a fast infusion, intravenous saline, you want to give that median pluvital vein. There are only two veins of the upper extremity. One is the cephalic vein and another is the basilic vein. Cephalic vein passes from the anatomical snub box above. It runs in this manner and opens into the axillary vein, and basilic vein passes to the medial aspect of the forearm, ascends upward, and that basilic vein also opens into the axillary vein, and these two veins are joined to each other in the forearm by the veins that join the cephalic and basilic vein. In the cubital fossa, there is a median cubital vein that joins the cephalic vein, the basilic vein. So whenever there is an emergency, you have to compress to the proximal side that the veins get full and they can be palpated easily, and you can pass the needle for intracath or that scalpel needle, you can easily pass to get the start the intravenous infusion. That is the clinical importance of the pluvital fossa. See, in case of an elbow joint, especially during the cycle, they fall on the elbow, and elbow is that extend only to 180 degree only. And if there is a forceful extension beyond that, the fracture of the olecranon process either, or dislocation of the ulna. Ulna is a stabilizing bone of the forearm. Ulna may get dislocated, and the olecranon process may get fractured here in the elbow joint. Now, three more clinical important points. Clinical important points of the shoulder joint is a frozen shoulder. In the persons in whom frozen shoulder is a clinical shoulder tip pain, shoulder joint is supplied by two nerves. So if there is a disease in the way of that femoral nerve, the musculocutaneous nerve, or from the radial nerve in their course, there is a shoulder tip pain, because that if there is, even in the thorax, C3 root value of a cervical third and fourth, if there is a disorder in the thorax, there is a pain in the shoulder. So such a pains are being called as a referred pains. खांद्याला काही झालेलं नसतं, देर इज नथिंग विथ द शोल्डर, बट पेन्स आर देअर इन द शोल्डर ॲट द टिप. सच अ पेन्स आर बिंग कॉल्ड ॲज अ शोल्डर टिप पेन. देन फ्रोझन शोल्डर, फ्रोझन शोल्डर इज नथिंग बट द अडेझिव्ह कॅप्सुलाइटिस. टू लेअर्स कॅप्सुलर लिगामेंट गेट्स अडेअर टू द इंटेरियर अँड पेशंट इज इनेबल टू डू अ फ्री मुवमेंट ऑफ द शोल्डर, दॅट इज कॉल्ड ॲज अ फ्रोझन शोल्डर. That commonly what happens to the shoulder joint, one is a dislocation, another is a frozen shoulder and shoulder tip pain. So if the patient can easily keep his hand, if adduction is very proper, this is flexion of the shoulder joint, this one is the extension, this one is an abduction, and this one is the adduction, bringing towards the central axis is adduction. If patient is able, tumcha dawakhanat patient ala, and if he says that he has a contusion on the shoulder, ask the patient, patient la sanga ki viruddha khandyavarti hat theun dakav. If he is able, to jar ya khandyavar hat theun dala, then there is nothing with his shoulder, and ask the patient to lift above 90 degree, असं करायला सांगा पेशंट. दॅट मीन्स देर इज नथिंग रॉंग विथ इज शोल्डर, नथिंग रॉंग विथ इज शोल्डर. देर आर नंबर ऑफ पॅट, फ्लेक्शन एक्सटेन्शन अबडक्शन इज टेकिंग अवे अँड अडक्शन इज टुवर्ड द अपोजिट शोल्डर. देन देर मे बी मिडियल रोटेशन, लॅटरल रोटेशन, देन द सर्कमडक्शन. क्रिकेटमध्ये बॉलिंग करतात ना, दॅट इज अ सर्कमडक्शन, मुव्हिंग द शोल्डर अराउंड इट्स ओन ॲक्सिस. दॅट इज These are the main important clinical things regarding the shoulder. Now, the clinical importance of the forearm, flexor aspect of the forearm. In the flexor aspect of the forearm, there is a radial artery and ulnar artery. Ulnar artery is a larger and that radial artery is a smaller. Then, there is a many clinical much more clinical importance of the flexor aspect of the forearm, except that intravenous infusions on the forearm is given when you want to introduce a big needle into the forearm, then to the back of the forearm there is much more clinically important structures in the back of your forearm, except that the radial nerve. I already told you, if the radial nerve is injured in the radial groove, only the extensor muscles of the forearm gets paralyzed, not the tricep. Medial